الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا نستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وعبد الله ربه حتى أتاه اليقين قال فيه رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى رؤوف رحيم صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذرياته والتابعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين أما بعد عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله أحثكم وإياها على طاعته أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته وأستفتح بالذي هو خير أما بعد يقول مولانا عز وجل في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر وربك فكبر وثيابك فطهر والرجز فاهجر ولا تمنن تستكثر ولربك فاصبر الفواتح or the beginnings of the المدثر سورة المدثر as you all know طبعا الخطاب here is to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الله تعالى is speaking to النبي المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله and he's telling him يا أيها المدثر and obviously المدثر is the one who is covering himself up with things or with a cloak or with what we call maybe today a blanket whatever it is that was there and Allah Ta'ala then is giving him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a series of instructions to al-muddathir and those instructions I feel especially these first 5-6 ayahs of surah al-muddathir examining them today on the way here I was looking at the surah especially the beginning of it, I said, Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in these first 5-6 ayahs everything that a human being needs in their whole life. And it summarizes the whole life of even us. And imagine now it's been directly given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then from him to us. The reason for that is because it's actual and actualized and practical and ought to be practiced. Ya ayyuha muddathir, it's not just a talk, it's an action that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing, covering himself with the cloak. Risala has come, the mission has been announced, meaning you are a prophet of Allah, you have a message from Allah Azza wa Jal. You received that takleef, Don't think that for us, yani, don't think that the takleef is tashreef only, but it's takleef as well. A lot of people, they take positions as tashreef. Yani, it's an honor. You know how we fight about positions, right? This microphone has a magical thing for some reason. Majib, I mean, everybody wants to, yeah, ta, come, pray, lead, bismillah, no problem. Learn, teach, practice, lead, bismillah, no problem. Lakin ajib, now we have managed to move Ayatul Kursi from an ayah for recitation, learning and barakah, just to reduce it to Kursi. And today we fight about the Kursi. You think all these things are happening about what? Kursi. Different slogans, different labels. It could be good label, good slogan, but a person with wisdom always looks beyond the slogan, beyond the presentation. Presentations, alhamdulillah, the world has managed to perfect the presentation. But the core remains what's needed for repair. Forget perfection. Repair because it's broken. Repair because it needs fixing. Repair because innama, like the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, innama al-ilmu bit-ta'allum wal-fiqhu bit-tafaqquh. Ma yiridu, there's a gradual step for things. There's build up for things. There's وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا. Allah Azza wa Jal said, those who actually do jihad, yani struggle in our ways, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا. We shall guide them, but they have to do jihad. It's jihad, it's so much struggle to seek us. The Arab poet says, مَنْ طَلَبَ الْعُلَى سَهِرَ الْلَيَالِي. Those who seek heights, they spend the nights up. But today we've changed it. Instead of sahira means spending the night up, we made it shakhira. Shakhira means to snore. Sahira means to wake up the night and no. You have a responsibility. You stay up the night to figure it out. But instead of sahira, shakhira, you just put two dots, it changes the whole meaning. And instead of waking, staying up the whole night, thinking and working, the whole night. But the problem is Ahlul Kahf woke up after 300 years. It seems like we have a prolonged sleep. Ya ayyuhal muddathir, you have a message, qum, stand up, fa'anzir. Now it's time to go and work. The risala and the position that Allah Azza wa Jal gave you, هذا المقام الكريم والذي حباك الله عز وجل به, مقام تكليف. This is a maqam of takleef. This is not a maqam of you just sitting and that's the talk is for us, not for him sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidah Aisha tells us that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith sahih, he did not even sleep the nights except little anyway. And the days, alayhi wa sallam, he was spent in the da'wah, in the servitude, in this. He divided his whole day, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, into three sections, apart for his Lord, apart for his family, and apart for himself. And the part for himself, he gave it to Allah Azza wa Jalla as well. Ya ayyuhal muddathir qum. It's time. Qum means stand. It's time to stand. فَأَنذِرْ. And it's time now to go and announce and move in that message. Now, if this is a mission, and life is short, obviously, no matter how long you live, life is short. Life goes like this, it's really short, and you earn whatever you put into it. And therefore, Allah Azza wa Jal is defining this life. And this life, Ya Rasulullah, ought to be قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Your whole life is almost standing. And that's why some of the ulama of the seerah, they say, and the hadith is not sahih to the best of my knowledge right now, it doesn't appear to me, and I can't cross it in my mind, lakin it's not sahih to the best of my knowledge, that allegedly he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when this ayah or the other ayah was revealed in Muzammil, he told the Sayyidah Khadija radiallahu anha, or when the ayah came, قم فأنذر, he said, لقد مضى, allegedly he said, لقد مضى عهد النوم يا خديجة. Time of to sleep is no longer there. There's no more time for sleeping, O Khadija. Why? Wallah, he feels the responsibility, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Didn't Allah tell him, إِنَّا سَنُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلًا فَقِيلًا, we shall account you with a heavy responsibility. Well, الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام understand, they have, يعني they're not, they have sensitivities, they understand the talk. Some people you need to give them a sign called إشارة, right? But the poet says, إِنَّ اللَّبِيبَ مِنَ الْإِشَارَةِ, يعني the smart person picks it up from the sign. You don't need to give him عبارة. There's two things, إشارة and عبارة. إشارة is a sign. عبارة, you have to spell it out. And the poet says the smart person doesn't need the عبارة. He understands it from the إشارة. So some people, you have to write them a book today. Not إشارة, not only عبارة, a couple of sentences. A whole book and he still doesn't get it. لكن الله عز وجل is leading us to the best of examples, understands with the, what Allah عز وجل told him. يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر. And he tells Sayyida Khadija رضي الله عنها, there's no time for sleep. And that's, you see how Sayyida Aisha رضي الله عنها tells us, he was spending the night so that I felt, I have to tell him, why are you doing this to yourself? قم فأنذر. It's a responsibility. You know the responsibility. Feel that responsibility. Walk with the responsibility. You already know, you already feel. Walk. Here are the instructions that will make things easy for you. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. Ya Rasulullah, always remember and declare your Lord as Akbar. Why is that? Why does this come after قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ, stand and warn, and then رَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. Because if you stand and warn, there will be challenges, there will be difficulties, there will be people who try to stop you, there will be things who will try to swerve you, there will be tests also by Allah Azza wa Jal for you and for those around you. And therefore remember in all that, that no matter how kabir or how grand the challenge is, or how grand kabir the difficulty is, Rabbuka Akbar. No matter what it is, remember that Allahu Akbar. If you are with Allah, nothing is grand. Allah is the Akbar subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore he told them, قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. You always have these things. This is normal. Normal in the lives of the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. Normal in the lives of the reformers. And no, see, if you sit at your home and you just worried about your food and drinks and you sleep and work and this, nobody's going to bother you. Go. No. If you try to reform, if you try to positively contribute, if you try to change things, then maybe things will not be received as well. If you don't do anything, there's no effects. Don't they always say there are no mistakes for those who don't work? But those who work, you'll find mistakes while they're working. When they're not making mistakes, that means they're not working, not doing anything. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. Remember, Ya Rasulullah, Allah is Akbar. These things may seem grand. These things may seem difficult. These things may seem challenging. These things may seem, they may make it, they blow it up to make it big. Lakin with Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah is Akbar and Allah will make you victorious. So long you are with Allah, you don't have to worry about anything. But if you are not with Allah, the kalam is not to us, no, not to Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you are not with Allah Azza wa Jal, everything becomes big for you. The smallest challenge becomes big. Everything becomes big. Everything becomes unachievable. Everything becomes so far. Everything becomes so difficult. Everything becomes hopeless. Everything becomes problematic. With Allah Azza wa Jal, everything becomes good. Why? The results are not with you. The effort you're accounted to do. Allah is not going to ask you about what happened to the result here or there. Allah will ask you about what did you do, not about the results. The results are with Allah Azza wa Jal, but the effort, your obligation to do. Well, that's where things happen. If somebody thinks that they actually control the results, they have problems with Iman to start with. Naam. Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, qum fa'anzir wa rabbaka fakabbir. And then he said, what? Wa thiyabaka fatahir. Thiyabaka fatahir. Thiyab in the Arabic language has actually maybe 8 meanings, to say the least. Thiyab means, if you translate it literally, it would mean clothing. Tahir, purify your clothing. Lakin thiyab is not really only clothing or garments. Thiyab has other meanings. Among them, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself would for sahihain in the both Bukhari and Muslim, when he saw Umar radiyallahu anhu and he explained to him, he said, bima awalta dhalika ya Rasulullah, what did you explain the garments? I saw you in good garments. He says that means in good deen. So then, wa thiyabaka fatahhir, your practice of your deen makes it purified, more pure. لأنه this deen is about practice. And it's about a process of purification. Yani if you started from the beginning of the deen and now you are in the deen 20 years, 30 years, 10 years and you haven't progressed, there's a problem. You're not walking on the ladder, on the step, the Quranic command, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِّرْ, and you should purify your practice of your deen so much until it is entirely selfless for Allah Azza wa Jal. There is nothing in you or of you that you see in your worship. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. إحسان is that you worship Allah as if you're seeing Him. You don't see anything but Him. You worship, but you see Allah Azza wa Jal, yani as if you're seeing Allah Azza wa Jal. You don't see yourself, nor do you see your worship. If you see yourself or you see your worship, you're not seeing Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وثيابك فطهر. Look how you can rise in the journey of Iman until you go there with ثيابك فطهر. لا سمو فسرين say ثيابك means ونفسك. ونفسك فطهر. يعني the khitab is for us more than for him صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. Some of us say وثيابك فطهر means وقلبك. وقلبك فطهر. Your heart makes it always pure. Purer and purer. Again, we're going in the same thing. Not the practice of your deen now, but the practice of your heart. But what's the point in that if you live your life and you're turning your heart into a garbage can? All kinds of negative and filthy emotions, you send them there. Hate, jealousy, envy, grudges, curses, whatever it is. And you send all these things, you put them in your heart, and you walk in this dunya with a heart as heavy as this. How do you think the journey to Allah Azza wa Jal will be? Drop all that and walk light to Allah. For the travel to Allah Azza wa Jal and the wayfaring to Allah requires light travel. And maybe light take it in both ways. Light versus heavy. Huh? Light versus darkness. What do you have? وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal says, those whom Allah does not give them nur will never get nur. وَثِيَابَكَ then maybe وَقَلْبَكَ, and this is something that the Ummah has to work on, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam led the Ummah to work on these things. That's what we call tazkiyah, that's what we call raqa'iq, that's what we call ihsan, that's what we call mahabba, that's what we call tarbiyah today. One of our problems that the Ummah faces today is because we've been saying that now for years, reducing the deen to set of information, sentences people memorize and they think they know the deen. Versus in the old days, people memorized much less. And they also, many of them knew less. Many of us today, I've always said that, people today memorize the whole Quran from the beginning till the end. the Meccan Sahaba, the Sahaba who were in the Meccan phase, who died before the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrated to Medina, they didn't know the whole Quran. They didn't memorize the whole Quran. Not possible. It wasn't revealed entirely then. But they had that tarbiyah. They had that transformation that actually they saw the light in the book. The problem was not that there's no light in the book today. The problem is the eyes don't see the light. Or the heart doesn't see the light. But their heart was purified so it could see the light in the guidance of Allah Azza wa Jal. And today when the heart is busy with everything else, and then we've substituted deen for information. Learn some information and buzzwords, or have some looks, bismillah. Memorize and you have deen. And therefore today we've created what is known as information bots. People walk with information, but when you come down, you put your hand to see the depth of nobility. I was talking to one of my shuyukh yesterday, Allah have mercy on him and give him health. He said, son, the issue of nobility, that's a big thing. I'm saying a noble sheikh. He says, it's nobility. He says, son, nobility, that's a big thing. And that's a difficult thing. What do you mean nobility? That's not easy for people to be noble. That's not easy. That's a lifelong process of elimination, illumination, purification, education, all kinds of things. Until people reach that level. And that's why when Allah Azza wa Jal described His Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, He did not say, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. He didn't say, you have a ilm that's azim, though His ilm is azim, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And He didn't say, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ نَسَبٍ عَظِيمٍ. Your nasab, Ya Rasulullah, is so azim. And His nasab is azim, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And He didn't say, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ مَكَانَةٍ عَظِيمًا وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ. Well, He says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Ya Rasulullah, you have reached the top. Nobility is, you are it. You have reached the maximum. How can you otherwise explain that when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes to Mecca after 20 some years of them persecuting him, killing his companions, killing his family, doing all these things, and he tells them, they tell him, as the ulama of the seerah mentioned, they say, he said to them, مَا تَظُنُّونَ أَنِّي فَاعِلٌ بِكُمْ. What do you think now your judgment ought to be? They know what their judgment, they're, many of them are a bunch of criminals and killers. قالوا, they replied to him, قالوا أخٌ كريم وابنُ أخٍ كريم. All we can say is that you're a noble person and your father was a noble person. Look at that. We can't tell you what to do because we know what we've done. But all we can say is أخٌ كريم. كريم doesn't mean generous here, huh? إنه لقول رسول كريم, as Allah says, which means not generous here, noble. Noble. They told him, you are a person of nobility. And your father is not strange to you. Your father was also a person of nobility. أخٌ كريم وابن أخٍ كريم. قال اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء. Go, you are all pardoned. And that's why we suffer today. We're suffering today among the crisis is not just disinformation or misinformation. No. The information itself is becoming a veil. Because information is not put to practice. It's just amassed. It's just collected. And we're thinking when we collect more information, we have more iman. But the Sahaba radiallahu anhum looked at it differently. They collect the information and they practice the information. Their iman rose. It was not just theory, it was theory and application. You remember that Sahabi, he was eating some dates in his hand and the call was Hayya ala jihad, it's time for jihad. He says, time for jihad, or should I finish the few dates I have? He says, no, that's a long time to finish the dates. Let me now answer the call of Allah and then the dates will always be there. There is an understanding here. It's not something that's magical per se. It's just something that's straightforward. Do I actually obey Allah and His Prophet or I obey my shaitan? Very simple. And therefore you see, Allah Ta'ala made that easy from the beginning between Adam alayhi salatu wassalam wa Iblis. It was the issue of tarbiyah and adab. As if Iblis went to his fire nature, Adam alayhi salatu wassalam went to his clay nature. And Allah Azza wa Jal, when he told them to do sujood, فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ, they all did sujood, Allah says, إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ, except Iblis. What is the answer? قَالْ أَأَسْجُدْ لِمَنْ خَلَقْتَ طِينَ. Oof. Iblis now is telling Allah Rabbul Izzah, which means you want me to do sujood like this. Look at the audacity. Won't remember your creation? Hopeless, helpless, weak, you know who you are, you know. No. Even you know, it doesn't make a difference, Ajib. This little thing of arrogance, huh? In the jinn and the ins. Shayateen al-insi wal-jinn. Yuhi ba'duham ila ba'd. Zukhruf al-qawli ghurura. He tells him, asjud, like this, without any adab with Allah Azza wa Jal. Sujudu li Adam. Do sujud to Adam. فسجد all the malaika do sujood illa Iblis. What is قال أسجد لمن خلقت. You want me to do sujood to that whom you create out of clay, out of earth? Then he tells Allah even more. أرأيتك هذا الذي كرمت علي. Even now goes, you see, once people slip in the, they think information helps them rather than actually observing Allah Azza wa Jal. طيب. He tells Allah, which means, do you see that one? Like this, أرأيتك is a way of disrespect. When it's like you're talking to someone on the same level. Who are you? Who are you? يعني مسكين in the sense that you are ضعيف. You are weak and you know you're weak. It's, you know, it's عجيب. You know how it is? It's like when people sin, when they are so in need of Allah. And they know they're in need of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah help us all. It's one thing when people are veiled by the gift, they don't see the giver. It's one when Allah tests people with difficulties and they still don't see. Oh, Allah is testing you and you don't see? Totally dead. Who khatam Allah? The Quran tells you, khatam Allah ala qulubihim. وَعَلَى سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَى أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةً. Allah sealed their hearts and their ears are sealed and their eyes have a layer. They can't see. قَالَ رَأَيْتَكَ هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ. You see that one that you honored over me? He wouldn't even name Adam alayhi salam. He says, he tells him, which means, you see that one which you've honored over me? لَإِنْ أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. If you just give me a little ta'khir, a little delay, you don't take me now. Look, he's willing to take himself now just for ego and arrogance. If you just delay me until qiyamah, لَأَحْتَرِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَّتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. I will take away from many of his offspring. You see, you honored him, I will put his children in Jahannam. I'll take them my way. Just give me that. What kind of shaitani hate you have in you? He did not say, Ya Allah, make the malaika do sujood for me. Adam did not say that to Allah. Adam did not ask Allah, ask Iblis to make sujood for me. Adam did not ask Allah, make Iblis make sujood for me. Adam alayhi salam did not say these things. Allah is the one who honored him. You have a problem with that? Yes. Why do you think that many of the problems, the people have a problem with Allah as the creator of things? أرأيتك هذا, you see this one that you honored over me? If you just delay me until قيامه لأحتنكن ذريته, I will take away many of his children just so you honor him to Jannah. I will take his children to Jahannam. That's what I'm going to do. قال اذهب. Allah tells him, which means go. فمن تبع, those who follow you among them, Jahannam is your final destination. Oh, that's what it is. the people who follow the shaitan today with the people who follow Adam today. That's the difference. The difference is clear. And the difference is in that. Notice how Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, when Allah asked him to not eat from the tree, and he ate from the tree. Right? Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "Ma'asa, ma'asa Adam rabbahu faghawa," and Adam did ma'asiyah of his Lord and was wrong. But then Allah says, "Fatalqa Adamu min Rabbihi kalimatin fataba alayhi innahu huwa at-tawwabur rahim." Adam alayhi salatu wasalam realized what he did, realized the wrong that he did. It's wrong. So when he realized the wrong that he did, he went and pleaded to Allah, "Ya Allah, grant me tawbah. Forgive me. Let me correct course." Look at the tarbiyah and look at the display of characters between both. These things you say, what do you mean tarbiyah and display of characters? Why do you think Allah Azza wa Jalla is bringing both for us? So we understand that this deen is not about information or about what you memorize, or even if you memorize the whole Quran, while it's a great thing. Like if you memorize the Quran and the practice is the practice of shaitan, what's the point? What's the point? Like Ibn Abbas allegedly says, many those who read the Quran is cursing them. Itself, the very Quran is cursing them. Allegedly. لكن هي حجة. Allah Azza wa Jal will to make his hujja on people. Everyone, كل نفس بما كسبت رهينة. Everyone is hostage to his and her own deeds and words. That's what you are writing your own, basically, a destiny, in a metaphorical way. طبعاً. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who grants everything. طيب. Well, that's the whole thing. That's why you see the characters in the, like Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, in the whole Anbiya, you see that adab in the whole Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Why? Observing Allah Azza wa Jal, they know. Ya ayyuhal muddathir, qum fa'anzir, wa thiyabaka, wa rabbaka fakabbir, wa thiyabaka fatahhir. Al-thiyab here, the adab, the akhlaq, the another meaning of al-thiyab is akhlaq, al-khuluq. You got to make yourself tahir, in a character way, characters, characteristics, the akhlaq, what makes you a Muslim. A lot of people think that what makes someone a Muslim barely is just la ilaha illallah, irrespective of what people do. That is true as far as embracing and entering the faith of Islam, but that's not what makes a Muslim in the fullest sense. Al-Muslim, al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, Sahih Imam Muslim, man salima an-nasu min lisanihi wa yadih, those who people are saved from his harm. Al-Muslim, akhul Muslim, it's all these ahadith about who the Muslim, and the Muslim here means a verb rather than a noun, the one who is in engaged surrender to Allah, that's the Muslim. He Muslim from Islam. Islam means surrender. But it's not passive surrender. It's actually engaged surrender. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal tells Al-Khalil, Ibrahim الذي وفى صلوات الله عليه, إذ قال له ربه أسلم. Allah tells Ibrahim, أسلم. قال أسلمت لرب العالمين. I am in total submission to Allah رب العالمين. That's why you see مثلا الأخلاق. You look at Sayyidina Yusuf عليه الصلاة والسلام. We know what Yusuf عليه السلام went through. Huh? From being a child, they threw his brothers. If you have brothers like this, who needs enemies? That's if they are not prophets. And according to most of the scholars, they're not. Allah Ta'ala forgave them at that time, at that stage, who needed enemy. And then Allah Ta'ala forgave them, and Allah Ta'ala gave them maghfirah, and Allah Azza wa Jal teach us from their lessons as well. So we avoid what they've done. They put their brother in the well. And from the well he went and he was sold into slavery. From slavery he went to a palace, then he went to the jail. And he was in jail many, many, many years. Some of the scholars say maybe more than 10 years. And notice when now eventually his parents come, his brothers come, and he is now the chief minister of Egypt, right? And now he tells them his story. He says, هذا تأويل رؤيا من قبل. Oh father, this seems to be the realization of my dream before. Remember my dream? This is now you came and you did sujood and everything. And then he tells him, which means Allah has done me a great favor. من الله عليك. إذ أخرجني من السجن قد جعلها ربي حقا. إذ أخرجني من السجن. Allah Ta'ala took me out of jail and made me. wait, he skipped what? He skipped, Allah Ta'ala took me out of the well. Well was more dangerous than jail. Jail, there was people. Government knew he was in jail. Well, there was nobody. But why didn't he mention that? He didn't want to make his brothers feel bad. They came and did tawbah. Why does he remind them that you threw me in jail? Oh, what does the ayah go? وَلَا تَمْنُنْ تَسْتَكْثَرْ. Do not always brag about the favors or the good things that you've done. Just to increase, I have done this. Suffice that Allah knows. Well, I've done this. Your actions speak louder than your words. Don't tell me what you've done. Show me what you've done. But even then you don't need to. And that's where, وَلَا تَمْنُنْ تَسْتَكْثَرْ. Do not actually brag about favors and good things that you've done. You're bragging about who? If it's a good thing, leave it for Allah Azza wa Jalla. He knows. That's why you see Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he goes and he tells them, إِذْ أَخْرَجَنِي مِنَ السِّجْنِ. He didn't even, he talks about the jail. He never talked about the well. He didn't want them to feel bad about it. مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ نَزَغَ الشَّيْطَانُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ إِخْوَتِي. And that's after shaitan has put this fitna between me and my brothers. He didn't even say my brothers did this. Shaitan put this trick between us and it led them to do what? Etiquette, mu'ad. Why? Observing Allah. Not severed from Allah. He's not working in the deen, severed from the observation of Allah. He's not a worshipper of Allah, severed from the observation of Allah. He's present with Allah Azza wa Jal and knows with what who Allah Azza wa Jal is. And he knows that the true reliance is on Allah Azza wa Jal. Adab, always people appreciate adab. I've always said, adab is always more appreciated than ilm. Trust me. Today we focus on ilm, we don't focus on adab. Well, adab fadalu an ilm. Adab is but characters, they people favor it more than knowledge. Al-Mu'tasim al-Abbasi, I tell you this. Al-Khalifa al-Abbasi, one of the Abbasi khulafa, he went to his wazir. His wazir, yani his minister, Khaqan. He went to his home to visit his minister, assistant. He saw his teenage boy. Khalifa. So he says, Ya Fath, his name is Fath. He says, Fath, he says, Naam, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Khalifa is talking to him. Khalifa is visiting his home. He says, so which is better, your home or our home? Where I live or where your father is? He says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, whichever home you're present in, that's the better home. Then tell. Tarbiyah, it means what? It means his parents, they educated this person. It means there's education. They actually worked on him. They labored. They labored. There's labor there. He says, "Ya Amir, whichever home you are in, that's the better home." طيب. يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر وربك فكبر وثيابك فطهر والرجز فهجر. And rujz means impurities, things that are not good. Whether in words, you see people saying bad words for no reason, profanity for no reason. Why? From you, you think you can make a better point with profanity? And that's the only way you can make a point? Impure words or impure actions. That's why in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hadith sahih al-Bukhari fi sahih Muslim, afwan, ma kana fahishan wala mutafahishan. He never used profanity sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You don't need to use these words to make your point across. You can still use decent words and Muhammadan words to use to get your point across. وَلَا تَمْنُنْ تَسْتَكْثِرْ. Obviously, all these things also is what bringing us up to levels that the Prophet ﷺ wants us to be, and Allah Azza wa Jalla wants us to be. Today, maybe the focus, again, at the end of all this is on how are we actually interacting in actions with the Book of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Maybe step back. If I am not good with my parents, then what difference does that make how much I know or how many ahadith I memorized? These are going to be against you, not for you. If I'm not good with my community, if I'm not transparent with Allah Azza wa Jal, if I don't favor that which is good which over that which is not good, then what are the use of all these things that you memorize? What's the use? What did you bring them for? What did you memorize them for? If we can't get our children and ourselves and all of us to be better human beings as the very first call of Islam, with ourselves and with Allah and with our parents and with our family, and طبعاً with our family especially, لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي. The best of you are those who are better to their families. So you want to be nice to me, but you're not nice to your father? Are you kidding me? Fix that relationship first and fix the others. Ya ayyuhal mudaththir, qum fa'anzir. Feeling that sense of responsibility. Feeling the observation of Allah Azza wa Jal in you. That you're not alone, and one day you will die and you will go to Him anyway. And you're going to have to answer. Fix yourself from now and go easy. Make it easier for ourselves. And that's why the old days, the mashayikh used to be people who, it was, you would live 20, 30 years and you would learn and you would serve and you would do. Now we tell them to serve, you tell them to do their work, they don't do their work. Forget serving. We lost this. Ya ayyuha al-mudaththir qum fa'anzir. وثيابك فطهر وربك فكبر عفوا وربك فكبر. Remember, nothing is big. Allah is akbar. وثيابك فطهر. And grow, make that deen, you're growing in the deen. It shouldn't be the same days yesterday and today should not be equal. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر. أشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وذرياته وأزواجه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ما اتصلت عين بنظر وسمعت أذن بخبر. عباد الله, اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه, راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه. تزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه. اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع ويعطي ويمنع ويصل ويقطع ويخفض ويرفع إلا الله. واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه. قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم. بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين, إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, أعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه. يا الله, anyone who wants good for Islam and Muslims, lead them to it and guide them to it. And anyone who wants otherwise, guide them to your path, يا رب العالمين. آتي أنفسنا تقواها, زكها أنت خير من زكاها, أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا, عافي مبتلانا, فك أسرانا, ارحم موتانا. يا الله, in this blessed hours of yours, in this blessed day of yours, in this blessed house of yours, in this blessed time of yours, forgive our sins, يا رب العالمين. Ya Allah, any of us and all of us who have any needs, Ya Allah, that are good for our dunya and akhirah, grant us those needs, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, there are people amongst us and our families and our friends and those we know and the rest of the people, Ya Rabbal Alameen, who are sick or who have some illness. Ya Allah, grant them ease and healing from you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, grant your rahmah and guidance to all people, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Grant us always to be united on the book of Allah that you sent us, Ya Allah, and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Purify our hearts, Ya Allah. Illuminate us, purify us, educate us, guide us, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Forgive our sins, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren, Ya Allah. Keep Iman in their hearts, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Keep Iman in their homes until Yawm Al-Qiyamah, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Until they come to you and you are pleased with them, Ya Allah. All of us, Ya Allah, our parents, our grandparents, and our great-grandparents, Ya Allah. Grant them Jannatul Firdaus, Ya Allah. Forgive all their sins, Ya Allah. Grant them parole into Jannah Janna and forgiveness, Ya Allah. Give them your mercy, Ya Rabbal Alameen. They have done what they knew as best, but you give the best, Ya Allah. So we ask you, Ya Rabbal Alameen, to give them the best that you have, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, for us, keep us living in a way that is pleasing to you and pleasing to your Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And make it a way that's productive and good, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, everything around us, turn it into the best of ways. Grant justice to those who are missing justice, Ya Allah. Grant forgiveness to those who are needing forgiveness, Ya Allah. Grant rizq, Ya Allah, to those who are seeking rizq, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And Allahumma ghfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka ya rabbana sami'un qareebun mujibun lid da'awat. Ya Allah, all the Muslims who passed away, give them forgiveness, Ya Allah. For those who have nobody to make dua for them after they passed away, Ya Allah, give them special forgiveness from you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Grant them Jannah and ease, Ya Rabbal Alameen. All of them, Ya Allah, send them the mercies from you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Fir lahum lana wa liwalidina mashakna man lahu haqqun alayna wa akhir da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad.